Hey dear friends, welcome back to the part 2 of Java I/O and the part 26 setting of Java. So let's get started. In the previous section I showed you the structure of output stream and input stream and the classes. Okay, we have. So let's get started here. As you know, outstream is byte in Java. So we can read byte. For example, if I use an output stream, okay, output. As you can see, out I can initialize to new output stream, but this is an abstract. You cannot make an object of abstract. As you can see, this has arrived method. Okay. So we need to this is okay. As you can see here, we have an output stream. Now if I this is as like as this, we have a write method in output stream, okay? When you cannot make an object of an abstract class or an interface like this, okay? Instead of this, you can put after this parentheses class bracket. Then you can write here. That's abstract method. Okay, you have arrive method which takes a parameter of byte, and then you can write byte. Okay, byte. Now if I use out dot write, for example, then. Are truth, are exception. Okay, let's run. As you can see, we have here 10. If you pass like this, as you can see this. Also, you can cast it to a constructor. To a character, okay. Now if you run this, you will get something like this, okay. And I think you know, as you can see, it is 8. 8 is actually 1000. Or if you want to print. For example, 64, that will print 8. Oh, sorry, 65. What's the thing? 65 is. Yes, it is. Okay. If you put like this. Then it will print A, B, C, D, E, okay? This is the work of output stream. So And also, you can pass a character, a cassive character to that, okay? So you see? For example, A, since he is that, if this was larger, capital A, it is fine. So thank you for your watching and see you in the next video. Goodbye.